Welcome to Anime Done Quick, the only show on the internet where I explain to you the entire plot of an anime from start to finish so you don't have to watch it. Let's face it, this one, it's not good. So you might be thinking to yourself, if this show isn't good, why are you talking about it? Well, it's Studio Science Saru, Masaaki Yuasa's name was stuck on it even though he had basically nothing to do with it, and it is, oh god, top to bottom, what the fuck is happening? If your favorite emotions are confusion, anxiety, annoyance, and occasional absolute hilarity, you're gonna love this anime, or at least you'll love me talking about this anime. So without further ado, let's just get into it. This is Japan Sinks 2020, done quick!
I'm not kidding.
Boom! Anime starts! We're getting introduced to our central cast. You got mom, she's flying in a plane. You got dad, he's up on a thing. He's doing some construction and he's building out like the Olympic stadium for the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. You got our main girl, Ayumu. She's running in the track and field. She's like a high school track athlete star. Pretty fucking sick. They're all chilling. Earthquake! Out of nowhere! It's pretty big. Things bouncing around, buildings wiggling. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. They're designed to do that. Earthquake, going down, see everyone's reactions. It's all fine, it's all good. Are you good? I'm good. Everyone okay? We're doing fine. All right, back in the locker room with the Yumu. She's looking at her phone. Everyone's like, damn, it looks like that was like a magnitude 7 down in fucking Okinawa or whatever. That's pretty bad. That's like the worst earthquake you can get. Alert goes off on their phone. Oh shit, what's going down? Another earthquake? What's going on? Maybe it's just an aftershock. Fuck no, it's no aftershock. Huge! Huge earthquake! Everything's getting wrecked! Little brother's getting thrown around in the kitchen, some shit hits him in the face, mom, fucking plane going down, oh shit, fucking lava's coming out of the ocean, dad, he's falling off the rafters, Ayumu, she gets fucked! Her whole team, wrecked! Everybody is fucking wrecked! Ayumu comes to, she's looking around, her whole team, annihilated. They're all, most of them, clearly dead. She looks up, there's one girl, and she's like, reaching out, covered in blood. Ayumu's like, oh god, bad thoughts, negative, getting the fuck out of here. Hell no with this shit. And she's running out, she cuts her leg, she's like, oh fuck, oh shit. But she's gone. You got dad, hanging from the rafters. All his friends, fucking dead. I gotta get out of here. Going into the city. Gotta get home to my family. Mom's plane has crashed into a bridge, it's in the water. She's swimming out. She's a fucking professional swimmer. She doesn't give a shit. She sees a little kid drowning. She's like, should I save that little kid? I don't know. All right, we'll save him. She saves the little kid. Going home. Ayumu's running home. She's running miles. She's running miles. She's running miles. She's the best runner in the fucking world. She gets to her house. Her house is fucking destroyed. Everything is gone. So she goes. She meets up with a bunch of groups, the group of refugees, basically. Everyone's fucked. And she's thinking about how her house used to have these lights and stuff, something about her house. She notices, off in the distance, these lights going up the mountain. And she's like, oh, fuck, that's my stupid dad's lights that he puts on the yard that everyone finds fucking annoying as shit, and they all make fun of us for it. But he clearly has put them on the mountain. Let's go to the mountain. Let's meet up with our family. She meets up with dad, little brother, nowhere to be found. Mom comes in soon after, little brother comes in soon after, he's got blood coming out of his eye, it's okay, they have a staple gun, they staple that motherfucker's eyes shut, he is fine. So people are gathering on the mountain now, explosions are going off down in the city, who knows what the hell's going on there, and then all of a sudden corpses are falling out of the sky in a comic fashion, just dead bodies, boof! Boof! And then you see a helicopter and it's going down with a dude hanging on it, boof! And then you cut up to a tree and there's like blood coming out of the tree, what the fuck? Episode 2 begins, slowing down a little bit. They stay the night on top of the hill. In the morning, everyone's checking their internet, checking their phone. People still have, they still got some charge going on. They still got their 4G LTE shit going on. They're checking the internet. People are showing, I think it was Okinawa. The whole island sank into the fucking ground. They're saying on the news, Japan is sinking. Shit is getting fuck. So some guy comes up the hill and he's like, the water level is rising hella fast. We're gonna get stuck on this mountain. We're not gonna have anywhere to go. We need to move on to somewhere else. So the whole gang, including the family, all these random people, and two more kind of important characters. There's this guy that Ayumu kind of likes, and he's like a secluded dude. We find out that his mom died. Very, very sad. There's this other woman who's kind of friends with the family. She was taking pictures of them and stuff. I don't remember her name. She doesn't stick around for very long. Big surprise. So everyone's traveling through the city, trying to ignore all the dead bodies everywhere, figuring out a plan. There's a big group of people, and they decide that some people want to go one way, other people want to go the other way. The main family decides they're going to go with this one girl because they want to go in the direction of where she's from so that she can confirm that her family is alive. So they all split up. We got the main characters, the main family, along with the secluded emo guy and the other random girl. They're all going to go their own way. They split off from this group of people. Those people go the other way. Our gang decides they're gonna go into the mountains. They think this is a safer path. They're gonna take the high road. They're gonna go through the wilderness. It's gonna be a fun hiking, camping trip for the whole family. They're having a montage, man. Mom and dad are having so much fun. This is where we learn that mom and dad are the most boring milquetoast parents of all time. They're basically perfect and untouchable, but I guess there's kind of a point to that. So they're having a fun montage. Dad's teaching them how to camp. Dad's teaching them how to hunt. Dad's fighting a boar. Dad is having the time of his fucking life. He trained his whole life for this shit. He was made for this. All those stupid skills, all those life hacks, all that bullshit, all that survival stuff that he was learning his whole life. Everyone called him an idiot. Everyone said that he was dumb. Everyone knew he was lame. And now it is paying off. He's super dad. He is on this shit. He is ready to go. Whole gang's traveling. Super dad spots a fence. It says, over this fence, there's yams. Don't dig for the yams. Don't fucking dig for the yams. And dad's like, oh, hell no. I want some yams, dude. I am the yams. And he sees the little yam flowers, and he's like, these are yam flowers. I'm gonna follow the trail. Oh, look, there's yams down here, dude. I'm gonna get my family some yams. I am the man. I am the yam man. So he's digging a hole. He digs like 8 feet deep into the ground in the span of like maybe 5 minutes. The daughter, Ayumu, she's walking along the fence. She sees another sign that says, warning, there are fucking old munitions under the ground from the war. And, you could die over here. Oh, fuck! Cut back to dad. He's got the shovel. He's going down. Ink! What the hell was that? Boom! Dad blows up. Dad, dead. Million pieces. Everyone's like, what? Dad is fucking ruined. His hand flies, slaps on the ground. Wedding ring on the hand. He is a million pieces gone. Dad is gone, out of the picture. Everyone's hiking on their way like nothing ever happened. Recluse guy, he's got broken glasses. He's falling behind, he's a little weak little bitch. Ayumu's like, dude, fuck this shit. My dad just died. I can't take this. These shoes, he got me these shoes. Fuck these shoes, they're making me think of my dad. I'm getting rid of these shoes. Mom is like, dude, why are you being a little bitch? We gotta keep going. Dad's dead. Get over it. Get a life. Let's keep moving. The gang is picked up by a dude driving a truck. For some reason, they decide that the hottest girl with them, the older girl, is gonna ride in the front with the creepy guy, and then the rest of them are just gonna go sleep in the back of this pickup truck. They are fine. Guy in the front saying some creepy shit to the girl. He's like, oh, there's no police anymore. I can do whatever the fuck I want. There's no rules. Truck's running low on gas. They stop at a gas station. Girl in the front of the car is like, I gotta go pee. I'm gonna go pee. This guy's filling up, smoking a cig, going, oh yeah. Oh, you know what's going down. So he walks around, sees her washing her hands, and he goes, I'ma get my sexual assault on! I'm gonna sexually assault everybody! So he comes walking up to her, she starts beating the shit out of him, they're back and forth, hitting each other, he pulls out a taser, he's like, I'ma tase you, mom comes out, now she's fighting him, beating up mom, mom's beating up him, tasing him, gets him on the ground, and then fucking girl is like, you're done, dude, kicks the living shit out of him. He is fucking wrecked, out of the picture, girl power, everyone wins, fuck that guy, he was an asshole, his glasses fall on the ground, older girl gives the glasses to recluse boy, and is like, here, you got new glasses, your glasses were broken, and now you got new ones, it ain't that special. So the gang takes a truck, drive for a while. They couldn't actually get any gas at this gas station. There was no gas. So they drive and they drive and they drive. Car dies. Now they're hoofing it. They're walking through the mountains. You see Fuji in the distance. Fuji adjacent territory. Main girl sees the older girl kind of flirting a bit with recluse boy. She likes him. I don't know how to feel about this. So she's like, she's tying her shoe and then she's like, hey, I gotta pee. You wanna go pee together? I guess she's gonna like tell her. I don't know if they're trying to communicate, like, oh, she was gonna be like, oh, why are you hitting on my boy? I don't know. They don't really get into it because they start going. We see one girl, the older girl, collapse on the ground. What the fuck's going on? All of a sudden we hear screaming in the distance, and a guy is going through on a hover pack with he's got a hang gliding hover pack thing, and he's like, don't go down there, don't go any lower, there's poison gas going across the ground. It's been released from the earthquakes. It released poison gas. You guys know what we're talking about because you saw Dr. Stone. If you hadn't seen Dr. Stone, you have no fucking idea what's going on. But we all watched Dr. Stone, so we understand what's happening. So this guy comes hovering down. He's like, that girl is dead. You need to get back up the hill or you're gonna die too. So main girl and everyone else is like, oh my fucking God, she's dead. And she's just dead on the ground, limp, just fucking wrecked, gone. Never, it was not relevant. So, hang glider guy turns out to be, basically PewDiePie. He is the biggest YouTuber in all of Japan. The little kid knows who he is. No one else would have known who he was if the little kid didn't know who he was, because of course little kid is super into YouTube. So PewDiePie is going, I have enough capacity to hold one more person on my hang glidey thing, and I can take them to safety, but they'll have to split up from the rest of the family. And the family's like, nah, we are staying together. We are in this for the long haul. And so PewDiePie's like, you know what? I'm gonna take off my hover pack. Y'all are cool. I'm going with you. We're hoofing it now. So now we have, we lost one member and we gained a new one. PewDiePie and the gang are hoofing it. They come across a convenience store and they're like, all right, it's time to stock up. So they go in. They're pulling, there's so much stuff on the shelves. This thing is like, no one's robbed this at all. They're getting items. Oh, we got water. Oh, mom's going, she's getting some tampons. Kids are going into the back and they find all those clothes. They're like, oh dude, this is sick. And then a little robot dog thing comes up and it starts talking to them saying that you're stealing. You can't steal, that's bad. And then fucking arrows are shooting at them out of nowhere. All of a sudden they're getting shot at with arrows and there's a crazy old man running around in the rafters like this is fucking, like this is Dead Rising. You got Dead Rising grandpa up in the rafters shooting arrows. Everyone's running around, stealthing around, how are we gonna get this guy? And then the little kid runs out, boom, gets shot. Episode 4 begins. Little kid got shot with an arrow. Turns out it just hit his Nintendo Switch, didn't kill him. Old man comes out, he's like, oh man, I didn't mean to shoot this kid. I was just trying to scare you guys with my arrows. Didn't mean to shoot anyone. Now you're cool. You can hang. This is, you know, this is the convenience store I've run it my entire life. I just don't like people stealing. I didn't mean to fucking almost murder a child. I took it a little too far. You guys are cool. So they're hanging out with the old man and they realize that all of Japan is becoming on a decline by rolling a marble across the ground. And so they need to get the fuck out of there because there could possibly be a landslide because they're on a cliffside. They get out of there with the old man and his truck. The whole fucking convenience store collapses into the earth. Big landslide. All done. So we're continuing on our journey. It's night now. Everyone's camping out. The old man sitting in his truck. We realize that he's been fucking popping pills and downing it with alcohol. He is a son of a bitch. In the scene, it's also explained that they're trying to do like a rescue plan with Japan. They're watching it over the internet and they're like putting people on boats and getting them out. So they're like, I guess we'll head in that general direction. The next day, they're driving along and God damn it, they run into this guy. Fucking Daniel. Daniel's on the side of the road going, hey guys. Daniel, of course, is a giant white dude with the fucking big old hair, and he is the biggest cancer that has been put on the fucking anime screen in decades. Daniel is fucking annoying as shit, but they pick up Daniel, and he's doing his stupid little goofy jokes, and they're like, man, we fucking love Daniel. Daniel is the shit. The old man's like, nah, I don't like foreigners. I hate all foreigners. Foreigners are dumb. But Daniel's like, hey guys, I know where we can get shelter. Let me fucking lead the way. We're going to this place. So they pull up in front of this fucking commune at night, and they go in, and the people are all welcoming, and they give them food, and they're sitting there eating the food, they're eating this curry, and the fucking little kid's like, man, this curry sucks, I like my dad's curry more, I miss dad. And then the recluse guy, this is like, he has this moment, and he cries over his curry, because his mom died while she was making curry, and he's like, damn it, my mom is dead, I'm finally coming to terms with this, and he lets it all out. And then the mom at the table is like, you know, this food's a little weird, what's going on with this? YouTube guy is like,
weed.
There's weed in the food. All this food contains marijuana! So they all get done eating their weed food, and they leave this place. They're getting a tour from, like, the president of the fucking cult. He's showing them around. They got solar panels. They got marijuana farms. They've got this place fucking fitted out for an apocalypse. They were ready for this shit. They saw the writing on the walls. They saw the prophecy. They knew that this was coming. So they all get shacked up in some yurts. I don't trust anyone on the planet who has a yurt. The minute you see a yurt, get the fuck out of there. Yurts and yoga. Do not trust them. Anywho, so the old man is sitting in his truck and he's like, I'm not fucking having any part of this shit. This is some spooky shit. And he's sitting there and he's freaking out. Fucking PewDiePie comes out with a bunch of pills. And he goes, here you go, old man. Old man's like, oh, give me pills. And he's like, I knew you were having withdrawals from morphine. You're addicted to morphine. You're having withdrawals. Here's a bunch of morphine. I don't know why they have morphine here, but they got fucking morphine out the wazoo for PewDiePie to access. So he gives the old man his morphine. We get another scene where now we're seeing yoga. Oh God, I warned you about the fucking yoga. There's just this naked woman and she's doing yoga in a foggy room and there's ominous music. I bet this is gonna turn into a big plot. What's going on here? Is there magic? Is there voodoo? What's going on? All I know is that there's some spooky fucking yoga because it's always cults and yurts and yoga. Anyone who's got a yurt is doing yoga and anyone who's doing yoga is in a cult. God damn it. Gang wakes up. Daniel's showing him around. People are doing yoga. The woman who's the leader of this cult can speak with the dead. She can commune with spirits. Ooh, and so they go and they see her doing that. And she's got this little boy, this little fucking poor autistic boy. He can't speak. And that's her son, I guess. And they got him. He's like a guy. He's special. I don't know. But the main characters now all kind of have to get jobs in the commune. Ayumu starts working in a hospital. And she's taking care of this dude who is, like, paralyzed from the neck down. He can't even move his face. All he can do is blink his eyes and tap his fingers. And he keeps tapping on the side of the fucking medical bed thing. And he's, like, tapping. She's like, why are you tapping and blinking, dude? What's that? What's going on? What's with all the tapping and blinking? Cut to nighttime. Mom and Ayumu have a bit of an argument. She thinks that mom is already hot for fucking Daniel. Fucking Daniel? She thinks she's hot for Daniel? And she's like, what the hell, dude? You don't even care that dad died. So she moves on. But there's a big party going on. Ayumu goes to the party and everyone, literally fucking everyone is there. She's going, people are dancing. People are doing lines of cocaine. Not only is this a marijuana farm, I guess it's a cocaine farm. Anyways, PewDiePie's over there smoking a fat blunt. Fucking social recluse guy is there. Can't remember his name again, but Ayumu's checking out the party. Her little brother is over there having like a fighting game tournament. They're playing a fighting game tournament on the screen. This party is popping. It's got everything. Cut away to a weird scene of mom sitting on a swing and Daniel's like cheering her up, doing his fucking stupid Daniel bullshit. Cock-a-doodle-doo. We get a little shot of the old man and he's sharpening arrows, shooting them off. What's he got going on? He's preparing for something. So we're back in the club. PewDiePie takes over DJing. He's like, I'm DJing. I'm the shit. And then a record plays. It's weird. And then it turns out it's Social Recluse Guys' record. He put on his shit. And he's like, come up here, dude. You're gonna throw down, dude. You're gonna mix, dog. Play your shit, dog. Play your shit. So he has this moment. He's coming out of his shell. He's doing his DJ thing. Ayumu's like, that's pretty cool. She walks out. And then this dude follows her. And she almost gets raped in an alleyway by this guy. Ooh, sketchy, but she headbutts him, gets away. PewDiePie sees it. He's like, dude, that was sick, dude. Nice headbutt, bro. I'm fucking high as shit, dog. And so they're sitting there, they're watching the sunset. PewDiePie's still baked out of his mind. And she's like, why are you hanging out with us? Why don't you just get the fuck out of here? And it's like, well, I think it's more interesting to just kind of stick around with the people who are still here. Ayumu goes back and I guess mends things with her mom and she gets a haircut. You know, oh, I got a haircut. I'm ready to move on. I'm ready to move on with this fucking story. But it's not over. You thought this episode was over? You thought it was coming down? Like that was the climax? Like doing lines of cocaine and almost getting raped was the highlight of this episode? Fuck no. Now, all of a sudden we got old man driving around on a hover round with a bow and arrow, killing motherfuckers left and right. He doesn't give a fuck. He's cruising through, legs up on the fucking dash, big grin on his face, fucking doing 360 no-scopes on motherfuckers. So he goes and he kidnaps the son of the cult, gets him in his car, driving his truck, loses his fucking mind with withdrawals from morphine, slams the truck into a wall, knocked the fuck out. We cut to a weird fucking scene of the mom in the opium den with the other guy who like runs the cult, and he's just banging her, man. He is graphically banging that chick. Episode 6, the old man. He's in a fucking jail cell underground, trying to get out. Fuck! He's having crazy morphine withdrawals. He is freaking the fuck out. The people are watching him through security cameras. They're like, we got him. We fucking got that old crazy bastard. He's fucking having morphine withdrawals. Fuck that guy. He got a Yumu. She's working in the hospital. She's sitting there with the dude who can't move his whole body. And then she finally realizes while this motherfucker's tapping away, oh my god, I think this is Morse code! Because she remembers last night she saw her little brother and he was clicking a flashlight in the air. He was trying to do Morse code to communicate to his dead dad that he loves him or whatever. Except he says that he doesn't know how to do Morse code, so he's just clicking randomly and hoping it works. But anyways, back to Ayumu. She's now communicating with this guy through Morse code. She's translating it through an app she has on her phone. The guy's blinking away and he warns her. He says, I am actually the head scientist who predicted all this shit to begin with. And there is a big fucking earthquake coming. Get out of here now. This shit is going down. Ayumu's running around. She's trying to warn the people. You gotta get the fuck out of here. Nobody's believing her. She goes to her mom. Her mom is like, all right, I've got you. I believe you. I follow you. Let's go. Let's try to warn these people. Everyone's like, fuck no, dude. Nah, shit's cool, shit's cool, we're safe, we're all good here, fucking Big Mama's got it all figured out, we are fine. PewDiePie's snooping around, he's been skeptical of this whole thing, he doesn't really like these cold people, he ends up going underground, discovering the old man trapped in the cell, and then shit hits the fan. Earthquake happens, it is popping off, chaos, chaos, chaos. We cut to a scene of this dude, and he's in their vault, I guess, that's full of gold and money, and he's like, I'm getting the fuck out of here, I'm taking this gold and I'm going. And then this lady shows up, and she whacks him in the head with a brick of gold, and she's like, I'm not letting you take any of this gold, this is my fucking gold, bitch. So she's heading out of the vault, and then all of a sudden, the Big Mama lady comes down with a fucking samurai sword, she's got a katana, she's like, y'all ain't robbing this shit, this is my shit right here. And then all of a sudden, these three beady-eyed snake men come out, and they've got guns, and they're like, we are taking this shit. So you got yourself a real Mexican standoff here. Everyone shoots everyone. Mom gets hit in the arm. Boom. One lady's dead. Fucking snake people are dead. This shit has hit the fan. PewDiePie and the old man get out of the cell. They were helped by a dude. Doesn't really matter. Everyone, including Big Mama and her boy, they're going to save the little kid. He's at the top of this tower thing. Mom and Dad run into the room, see the little boy. He goes, Mom, thank you. These are the first words he's ever spoken in his life. And then a giant rock falls down, bangs him in the head, dead, flat fucking dead. So Mom and Dad are freaking out. They've got the little boy. They're like, oh, Jesus fucking Christ, he died. Old man and PewDiePie come up. They were going after him too. They're like, oh, yep. Yeah, he dead. Colt, Mom and Dad decide they are gonna stay with son and just let this fucking place collapse on them. They don't give a shit. PewDiePie, he gets the old man on his back and he's like, I'm getting you the fuck out of here. And then that guy bites him in the back and is like, hell no, I am staying, I'm too old, I'm slowing you down. Just let me die with all this shit, I can't take it anymore. And then PewDiePie goes, parting gift, gives him a bunch of morphine and he's like, this is my last supper. So the whole family and PewDiePie, everyone's getting away in the pickup truck that was the old man's truck. They're driving away and all of a sudden these dudes are shooting at him with guns because I guess they were mad that they fucking went after, I don't fucking know, they think they caused the earthquake, who gives a shit. They do have the paralyzed man with them in the truck. They managed to get him out. And then these people are shooting at him with guns. The old man from inside of the big tower thing, he's shooting arrows. He has his redeeming moment. And he's like, I'm not racist anymore, guys. I'm the coolest. And he has accepted death. And then all the cult people decide they are gonna go with the cult mom and cult dad and cult son at the top of the tower, and they're just gonna die. They're like, this is my home, you're my family, I don't know what the fuck I would do if I weren't here. They're like a ragtag group of like ex-criminals and stuff. Daniel's there with them, thank God Daniel stayed. The whole thing collapses on everyone, they're all dead. Daniel's dead, oh yes, thank God. Thank God Daniel's dead. We're back on track. Done with the cult bullshit. We're going to those boats that we learned about a few episodes ago that are gonna take everyone out of Japan. Japan is fucked. Family arrives at the big boat. There's tons of people trying to get on. So we learn there's a selection system. Only so many people can go. It's based on like a random lottery based on the end of your, essentially your Japanese social security number. There's also apparently a bias towards young, talented people. Now, the only person from the group who is selected to go is Ayumu. She has permission to board the ship. So everyone's saying goodbye to Ayumu. She has this big dilemma of like, do I go? Do I stay? I don't know. Everyone's like, you gotta go, dude. You gotta go. At least one of us needs to get the fuck out of Japan. Some of us need to survive this shit. You need to go. Ayumu hugs her mom goodbye, and she feels something weird when she gives her a hug. Not too worried about it. She gets on the boat, and then she's thinking back. She starts doing some Googling. She Googles, heart assist battery, and she realizes, oh fuck, my mom has a device that's keeping her heart alive. So she decides, fuck this, gets off the boat. She had a little wristband that she got that marked her as a worthy passenger. She hands it off to some little kid who couldn't get on. She's like, fuck that shit. She goes to mom, she's like, mom, what the fuck, I'm staying with you, let's get out of here. All of a sudden, Fuji-san is gonna blow. Big earthquake's coming out. Ships gotta get the fuck out of here. Fuji, fucking fuming. Earthquakes are coming. Family magically gets back to their truck. They pull the fuck out. Luckily, they were the last car in a long line of cars. So then they're in the perfect position to get the fuck out of there. They're driving along. Shit's hitting the fan. All of a sudden, like some shrapnel flies out. Hits fucking recluse guy in the shoulder. Goes right through him. He's fucked. They drive away. They gotta help him. It looks like it didn't hit any of his major organs, so PewDiePie gives that motherfucker some morphine, and they get on that shit and they yank it out! Bandage him up, he is fine. So they're driving away, they're looking at some stuff on their phone about how Japan is gonna sink. It's there's magma and stuff, it's gonna go! Plates are shifting, Japan is fucked! This is happening now! So they get to, like, a port town, and they see this big ship off in the distance, and it's full of Japanese nationalists. They're all waving their flags, shouting on megaphones about how the Japanese race is fucking awesome and stuff, and they're like, well, this is the best option. We better go fucking get on that ship full of Japanese nationalists. They go and they meet up with some of these nationalists, and they are like, y'all some foreigners, because the mom is Filipino, and the youngest son is obviously like mixed Filipino, the daughter's mixed Filipino, they are not pure Japanese. So they're like, mom, you cannot go, this is a pure Japanese only vessel. And then they're like, come on dude, these kids are half Japanese, their dad was full Japanese. And the nationalists are like, well, we will take, you know, because the kids are only half, like if you put both of their Japanese halves together, we could take, like, we can only take one, because that would make up for, like, the other foreign half that you're leaving behind. Ridiculous shit. But they're like, fuck that, y'all are clearly psychopaths, we are not going on the nationalist ship. So they end up finding this Japanese man, who's like, I'll take y'all, I got a fishing boat, this is gonna be sick. So they get on the water, shit's hitting the fan over in Japan, Fuji's erupting, they gotta get the hell out of here. Japanese nationalist ship is having a fucking luau. They've got big speakers blasting, and all of a sudden, there's just a fire breaks loose because of bad electrical work or something, and that shit explodes. Nationalists are on fire everywhere. They're running off the ship, jumping in the water. Their ship fucking explodes. Shrapnel from that ship comes up to the ship with the main characters on it. Boom! That ship is sinking now. Everyone's gotta get off. The old man running the ship is like, we need to get the women and children into this lifeboat. So, Ayumu and the little brother get into the lifeboat. And then this other dude comes out with a fucking gun. And he's like, fuck women and children, I'm getting on that shit. And then all of a sudden a big wave comes, washes everyone out. And the old man who owns the boat ends up in the lifeboat with Ayumu and the little brother. We don't know what happened to any of the other characters. It's just these three. They're in the boat for a little while. The old man's hacking up blood. He's kind of fucked. And they unzip the thing. It's nighttime. The sky is dark. And they notice that they're seeing the tops of buildings around. Japan has sunk. It is gone. It's all water now. We're in the life raft. Ayumu, little boy, old man. They're hanging in there. Old man hacking up blood. He is, he's kind of fucked. They all go to sleep. Ayumu wakes up. The old man is laying halfway out of the boat, and there are gulls eating his corpse. He is dead. Gulls fly away, she scares him away, and it's just fucking ribs and organs popping out of him. She's like, oh my god! And then a shark comes out and eats that motherfucker. What? So, Ayumu and her brother are alone now, on the water, drifting. They have limited supplies. They don't have any food. They don't have any water. They had the one candy bar that the YouTuber gave them a long time ago. Doesn't really matter. We get some really beautiful scenes of Ayumu and her brother bonding, thinking about, man, I miss Starbucks. I miss some fucking dank-ass frappuccinos, bro. I can't wait to get myself a mocha again. Starbucks, that was the shit. They're doing some fun survival stuff. They catch a bird. They make some sashimi. They poke a hole in their raft. They try to drink some water, but the rainwater is full of volcanic ash. There's a bizarre dream sequence where dad comes into the boat and is like, hey, what's up? I'm your dad. It seems like all hope is lost when all of a sudden, out of nowhere, it's mom on a boat. Mom and the recluse guy somehow managed to get themselves on a fucking rowboat and just stumbled upon Ayumu and her little brother just floating around. And so now they are towing that boat with recluse guy fucking rowing. Very inefficient, obviously very inefficient. There's some nice little scenes with mom kind of bonding with her kids. All of a sudden, mom isn't the worst, shittiest, lamest character in the world, so you know she's gonna die. And then they get to a point where they find this motorboat with gas in it, and they're like, oh shit, we gotta get this motorboat. But there is a rope, there's like an anchor rope coming off of it, going into the water. They're not gonna be able to move this boat. Now, mom's battery just died. She had been charging this battery that keeps her her heart circulator thing going, and it was solar powered, and the sun is hidden by all the volcanic ash. So she can't charge her battery. She is gonna die. It's running out. She decides, I'm gonna swim down because I'm a professional swimmer in the Olympics or whatever. I'm gonna swim down. I'm gonna get this rope loose, and I'm gonna let you all go. I'm gonna die doing this. Everyone knows she's gonna die. So she swims down. She frees them. She's swimming back up, and she can't quite make it. So they jump in the water. They pull mom out, and they have a long, drawn out, very fucking sad scene of doing CPR on mom. It's quite grueling. You just finally decided that this character's okay. Now she's dead. Bye, Mom. Episode 9 begins. Mom, dead. Gotta move on. She's fine. She's in a better place. Ayumu puts on her shirt and her necklace. Little weird. The gang takes off on the speedboat. They're heading in the general direction of the coordinates that the scientist guy had given them previously of their, I guess they're supposed to be a safe place. They don't really know where they're going, but they make a little compass. They're heading that way. While they're speeding along, all of a sudden they run into PewDiePie, and he is in a fucking, like a tank, like a warship tank thing. Like, it's like one of those tanks that they use to like, to beach and let a bunch of troops out. I don't know why the fuck, I don't know where he got this, but he's in that shit. PewDiePie somehow rescued the scientist guy. He gets everyone on board, and they're like, we are gonna go to this guy's research facility where he was compiling data, and like, he has half this data set, and we need the other half of the data set. We need to get his hard drive with his research on it so we can know what the fuck is gonna happen next. Along the way, they stop off at this mountaintop. There's kind of a hot spring going on. They all chill in the hot spring, and then you have probably the most amazing, hilarious scene in the entire show where everyone sits around and PewDiePie decides, I'm gonna play some lo-fi hip-hop off my phone and y'all are gonna have a rap battle. I'm starting this shit. We are having a rap battle now, and they do, and it is funny as fuck. They kind of rap, airing their grievances about Japan and sort of coming to a consensus with all the shit that's been going down. Did Japan deserve this? Probably, no. They continue on their journey and they find this ridge that's above the water, and there's a cave in that ridge, and that's where that motherfucker's research facility is. PewDiePie goes full Death Stranding. He is a Strand type YouTuber. He is on this shit. He hauls a scientist guy through the cave, up a flight of stairs, and into this room where he's got a computer. This is his computer. He starts trying to fucking crack into that shit. He's thinking, what would Tom Cruise do, man? What would Tom Cruise do? All of a sudden, the island starts sinking, or hill, mountain, whatever the fuck it is. It's sinking. Shit's sinking underwater. Water's rising. He's like, what would Tom Cruise do? What would Tom Cruise do? And then water rises up. It fries the computer. He very quickly, quick thinking, he takes the hard drive and he puts it in a plastic bag, zips that shit up, grabs an oxygen tank, straps the scientist to his fucking stomach, and starts swimming like a motherfucker out of there. PewDiePie gets the scientists out of that shit. They're sharing oxygen. Turns out, the oxygen had run out. The scientists didn't get to breathe any of that shit. And so, PewDiePie's doing CPR on him. He drowned. He's like, motherfucker, wake up! And then it works. The scientist is still alive. CPR successful. Scientist guy is saved, but a big wave comes. And they're trying to get out of there. Little brother trips and falls, gets washed away in the wave, and the hard drive, for some reason he had the hard drive in his hand, encased in the plastic thing, it washes away, and it goes down this sort of little cement bridge, and it gets stuck in this little walled off area. So they're sitting there like, fuck, we need this hard drive, I guess, to save Japan. I don't know what their plan is here, but they need that shit. It is very important. So they're watching the hard drives getting blown around by the waves, but it's off in the distance. And then Recluse Guy starts counting the time in between each wave. And he determines that there's 17 seconds. If he can run across this little submerged bridge in 17 seconds and grab that hard drive and get back, they can be saved. They can basically save save Japan with this hard drive? I don't know what their plan is. So he's like, I got this shit. And they're like, no, you can't do it, dude. No one can run that fast. It's fucked. It's not worth it, dude. And he's like, nah, bro, I got this shit. This is my life's mission. I'm a new man. I'm a changed man. I can do this. This is my fucking destiny. And so he fucking runs. He is just having an orgasm while he runs. He is having a big cum getting this hard drive. He grabs that shit. He's running back. He's like, I ain't gonna make it. He throws that shit. PewDiePie catches it. And then, boof, gets washed away by a big ol' wave. Recluse Guy is fucking dead. He had his moment. He is gone. PewDiePie stands up on a fucking, on the cliffside. He's like, God damn it, you motherfucker. Come back here and race me, you bitch. You can't die before me. Race me, motherfucker. Episode 10, we're here. Final stretch, boys. Alright, so, episode starts off. PewDiePie has the hard drive that they rescued from the cave. For some reason, he has some kind of fucking SATA to lightning bolt hard drive reader. He reads the hard drive on his phone, and he finds out that the end of the research that the scientists had been conducting determined that while Japan has sank, it will rise again in the future. PewDiePie determines their location. He's like, wait a minute, we might be in luck. He creates, they lost their fucking, their submarine thing, and so he gets together all of this random shit, and he creates a raft, and he's like, we're getting the fuck out of here on a raft, dude, trust me. He's fucking paddling the raft along, everyone's on the raft. He stumbles upon a balloon. He's like, fuck yeah, it's here. It's a weather balloon. He pulls it out. He rips that shit and he's like, only one person can ride this weather balloon. See ya, y'all. And he takes off into the sky on the weather balloon. But he left his phone. So the main characters are like, did he just fuck us over and just get the fuck out of here by himself? He betrayed us after all this. But it turns out that the weather balloon is used to send an internet signal. So he flies up into the sky and then their phone gets internet. And that alerts his people to come by in a helicopter and pick them up. The gang is saved. Kite's friends come by in a helicopter. They got the SOS. We don't know what happened to Kite, but the gang, they made it. Ayumu, her little brother, and the scientist got out of Japan. They are taken to Russia, the closest thing to Japan, you know, up in the north. Now they're in this hospital, and guess what? I haven't been talking about it, but Ayumu scratched her leg in the first episode while she was abandoning all of her friends to die, and that wound has been shown in, like, every single episode. It has just been festering this entire time, and for some ungodly reason, she never thinks to do anything about it. It's probably a metaphor. I don't really know. But anyways, it's gotten to the point where they gotta amputate her leg, and they do that. Ayumu's doing fine. She lost her leg, but she's all good. She hooks up with her little brother, and they start watching. He's got the parents' laptop or a hard drive or something, and they're looking at pictures, they're looking at old videos of their parents. It's real fucking sad, real fucking sad. Anyways, cut to 8 years later. 8 years later, we're in the future. Neo Tokyo has been reborn. Around the highest mountaintop, they have constructed a city that floats on the water. It's fucking Tokyo and it's back, and the Tokyo 2028 Olympics are being held. That shit is lit. Team Japan's walking in, everyone's like, yes, Japan, you survived. You're the coolest ever. You're the most perseverant race of people in the world. We love the Japanese. There's a big video game fucking gaming tournament going on. Turns out the little brother Go, he's a fucking sick ass gamer and he's winning the tournament. He wins the gaming tournament. He takes it home for Japan. Gaming Olympics, that shit is real. Ayumu sees that shit and she's like, I'ma win that shit too. You watch me, dude. It's my turn. We get a little cutaway of the scientist guy, and I guess he's now embodying Kite's YouTube channel. Kite was PewDiePie. He is now PewDiePie. He's sitting in a chair, and PewDiePie is now a VTuber. He's like a CGI model, I guess. It's all implied. We don't really know, but I guess PewDiePie died, maybe, and now he's a VTuber. Up for debate. Anywho, we get to the end, and Ayumu, she's got a big old spring leg, and she's ready to go. She is running at the Olympics, and she's doing it. She's gonna fucking do it. Yes! And end of anime. There it goes. It's over. That's all you get. Beautiful, cute little ending. Feels pretty good. Warm, fuzzy feels inside. All right. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Anime Done Quick. It was a fun ride. In all seriousness, I did really enjoy this show. I think it obviously has a lot of faults. It probably had a lot of production issues. It's hard to really say unless maybe someone comes out and does an interview about it. But it's just a beautiful train wreck. There's parts of it that are profound and really good. There's a lot of it that's just insufferably terrible. Daniel makes me want to blow my brain out. But if you took like the first couple episodes and the last few episodes, like those last three episodes are really strong. I enjoyed them a lot. I left the show feeling like I didn't regret watching it. So if you thought it seemed interesting or hilarious watching this video, I encourage you to go check it out. I don't think this should be a show that is just lost to time, because it's special in the way that it's just like, what the fuck else is like this? It's so unique, it's so outlandish, and just ridiculous, and it's funny pretty much in every episode. It only drags at certain times. The dialogue is fucking odd. Everything about it is weird, and I think it's really like a it's like the fucking, it's almost like the room of anime. It's almost like a Garzy's wing of the new generation. It's hard to explain, but I get really excited talking about it. Obviously, I skipped over a lot of details, so if you're interested, check the show out on Netflix original anime. But anywho, this has been Anime Done Quick. Subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this, if you're new here. Thanks for watching the video. We do lots of anime commentary stuff. We do lots of podcasting stuff. We do video game stuff. Me and my wife run this channel. It's a fun time. Here on the screen, you've got patrons. We have a Patreon with bonus content. There's bonus episodes. There's a bunch of stuff already up on there if you want to blow a bunch of time listening to long podcasts. And give us, you know, throw us a couple bucks if you want to support this kind of content and encourage us to make more of these styles of videos. Anywho, see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.